Hi everyone. Today I am going to discuss topic market basket analysis. Today we have a large amount of data available with us. But with this massive amount of data continuously collected and stored, the market or business analysts are interested in finding out what could be very effective for them. What could be the business patterns that can help them in marketing or retailing? So we have market basket analysis, which could be used as a modeling technique effectively for this purpose. All we need to do is to understand the various terms and methods associated with market basket analysis. So today I'll be discussing various topics like introduction to market basket analysis, applications of market basket analysis, association rules, which include support and confidence, and an example associated with market basket analysis. So the name market basket analysis was basically derived from the idea that customers usually throw all their purchases in a shopping cart or a market basket during grocery shopping. So the basic idea behind market basket analysis started from the very fact of grocery shopping. This is basically a method which could be used for data analysis for marketing and retailing purpose. It basically determines which products customers are likely to purchase together. The strength of this market basket analysis basically lies in using computer tools for the mining and analysis purpose. Actually, there is a very interesting story behind this analysis, which is known as the beer and diaper story. There was a chain of supermarket in US which analyzed the various buying habits of customers for beer and diapers on weekends, and they found a very interesting relationship between those buying patterns. It was found that the customers usually buy beer and diapers on weekends together. Though the reason behind this could be that the fathers with kids are not able to visit pubs very often, so they stock their beers at home, or maybe that they are planning to go for a weekend to enjoy their weekends with their kids, so they are getting the supplies for their kids as well as for them. So when the supermarket found that there is an increase in sales, they decided to place the diapers and the beer next to each other so that this could result in increased sales. Now we have a number of applications where market basket analysis could be used. The very first is cross-selling. What happens in cross-selling is that when we know the different products that could be purchased together with the customers, whenever a customer buys one of the products, the vendor offers the other product with it. For example, whenever we visit MACD, the vendor usually does is whenever we buy a burger, the vendor offers fries or Coke with that burger. So this is basically an example of cross-selling. The next application could be product placement. When the vendor knows that the customer is likely to buy two different products together, what he will do is that he will place the two products next to each other so that it could help him to increase the sales of both the products. The third one is catalog design or store layout. This application is basically for web stores where the vendor wants to sell his items. So for that, what he does is he places the products near to each other which are likely to be purchased together by a customer. And the last application includes the loss leader analysis. Loss leader analysis is basically a pricing strategy. In this, one of the products is kept at a price which is lower than its market cost. Whenever a user comes or a customer comes to purchase that product, he is likely to purchase some another product with it. The other product that is likely to be purchased is capped at a higher price. So the vendor basically draws his profit from the selling of both the products together. Now, how can we find that the two products can be purchased together, are likely to be purchased by the customer? For this, we have different association rules. So an association rule is one in which we have an antecedent which is followed by a consequent. So whenever the item at the left hand side is purchased, the customer is also likely to purchase the consequent item. We have two measures for finding out the interestingness of an association rule. The two measures are known as support and confidence. So, in general, an association rule is defined as A implies B with a support S and a confidence C. Now, what is this support? Support basically defines the percentage of transactions that are likely to contain both the items A and B. For example, if I take bread and butter, the number of transactions that contain both bread and butter are likely to give the support for an item. Next measure for interestingness is confidence. Confidence basically defines the percentage of transactions containing A which also contain B. It is calculated as if we have transactions that contain both bread and butter, then the probability of those transactions has to be divided by the number of transactions that contain bread. So this will give you the confidence for the rule bread implies butter. An association rule is always considered interesting only if it has a certain minimum support threshold and a minimum confidence threshold which is satisfied by the association rule. So now we'll discuss an example which is related to finding out the association rules. Now we'll discuss an example related with market basket analysis. So this is a transaction table which is showing the different transaction IDs and the items which were purchased in these transactions. So we have four transactions named as T1, T2, T3 and T4, and these are the various items purchased in each of the transactions. The minimum support and minimum confidence for this particular example has been taken as 40 and 65 respectively. So first of all, we want to find out that whether an association rule which relates to trouser implies to shirt is a strong association rule or not. So for this, we'll write down all the transactions, that is T1, T2, T3 and T4. Now we'll see that what items were purchased in transaction T1. So in transaction T1, there was a pair of shoes, trousers, shirt and belt. So for all these items, we'll write 1 in the transaction table and the rest of the items we'll write 0. Similarly, for transaction 2, we have a pair of shoes, trousers, shirt, hat, belt and scarf. So all these are written as 1. In transaction 3, we have two things, that is shoes and shirt. Therefore, for shoes and shirt we have written 1 and in rest of the items we have written 0. In transaction 4, we have three things, that is shoes, trousers and belt. So we have written a 1 in shoes, trousers and belt and rest entries are made as zeros. Now we have to calculate the support for this particular pair, that is trouser and shirt. So support is given as probability of A union B. So what we'll do, we'll see that in which entries we have 1 for both the things. So in transaction 1, we can see that we have a 1 for trousers as well as for shirt, and similarly in transaction 2, we have a 1 for trousers as well as shirt. But in rest of the two transactions, we have 0 either for trousers or for shirt. So we'll consider it as 2. So A union B will be 2 and the total number of transactions is 4. So we'll calculate the probability as 2 divided by 4, that is 0.5. So the percentage comes out to be 50. Now this 50 is compared with the minimum threshold support, which is 40. So this 50 is greater than 40. So we can consider this. Now we'll have to find out the confidence for the same pair, that is trouser and shirt. To find out the confidence, we'll find out the probability A union B, which is divided by the probability of A. So probability of A union B, we have already calculated for support, that is 2. Now what is the occurrence of A? A stands here for trousers. So how many times trousers have occurred in the transactions? That is, we'll count from here. This is 1, 2 and 3. So it is written as 3. Now we'll divide this and we'll get it as 0.666. The percentage comes out to be 66.6%. Now we'll compare this percentage with the minimum confidence value, which is 65. It is again greater than the value. So we can say that the association rule trousers implies shirt is an interesting rule. Similarly, we can find out for any pair of items, that whether the association rule will be an interesting one or not interesting.